So tough to get a clean cut there. So guys, we are jumping into game number five. It's Nikov and Miguel against Fire and Togao. After four very intense matches, we are now down to Hidden Peak Civilization. And both teams went for Hans and Mayans. This was ne me nearly. And the Master of Masters of Arabia 2v2. It's Mibble.
I was just looking at the civilizations and wondering if we were going to see any full meso wars. Hang on, I'm getting a nudge. I need to get Membin because he crashed, so let me just force him into the game room while
Okay.
you can continue.
Okay, sure thing. And yeah, Hans and Mayan, so most likely teams want to go for the strong axe bow knight composition here. Hans survival, so many strategies possible, and Mayans with their cheaper axe bows. Such a great unit. So he's already laming me, says Miguel, who only got rid of one sheep, so that's not the worst thing ever. And is losing maybe some HP in the TC. No, not really. And Fire is going for the probably early lane. At least he was scared of an early lane against him, and yep. Was just patrolling in front of his own boar here. Everything right with them?
Yeah, everything's fixed.
Yeah.
I just missed it. Who's laming who? Like, who did
No,
anyone lose a ball?
nothing going on. I'm just hyping random patrolling in the base because it's the start of the game.
Yeah,
So.
because I've seen some free pick games in this tournament so far, and everyone went Mezzo Wars, and I was wondering, is it really optimal? Like you said, having at least one player being able to do knights and eventually paladin is really powerful. And we've already seen two games today where we had these players playing as mezzo civs, and neither of them could win against Koreans and Teutons, was it? So I do like that they went with Mayans and Huns in the end. I think that would be my pick.
Yeah, so true. So someone in chat, SMB, is asking, is it an option to go for Eagles Calf Archers here? What do you think?
I don't know. That's such an unorthodox thing. Castle Age Eagles, do you mean?
Yeah,
It doesn't seem
exactly.
that viable to me.
Yeah, indeed. They're performing pretty poor against. Yeah, mass expos and against knights, so most likely we will see that composition in, yeah, not top expert tournament games, but maybe more fun setting because, yeah, it's just not strong enough. Pretty open map here for Miguel, I have to say, and yeah, Nikov needs to do his work as well to go into lots of walling. Needs to wall close to his TC for sure. And yeah, seems like all the maps aren't that tight. Togao probably has the most wallable map here.
Important to note, Fire did eventually steal a ball from Nikov.
Yeah, we
Quite a
saw
late
that.
steal. Okay, I
Yeah.
didn't know if you'd seen it, because it only happened like 30 seconds ago.
Yeah, but I
Fun.
have the all-seeing eye, and they actually wrote in the chat, so that makes it easy
Okay.
as well. What else did I want to say? Nikov, in the other games, he was super early with his boars, but this time he had close deers, and therefore, yeah, didn't focus on the boars that early. Should click loom now, and then go up any second. Oh, there's a 20 villagers now, trying to go for loom. And Miguel actually going for a higher pop, as it seems.
He said man at arms.
Miguel said M at arms.
Yeah, he's gonna go man at arms rush against Degas.
Ooh, interesting stuff. And yeah, we kind of had two engagements already in the other games when Dogao and Miguel clashed in early feudal age and went so incredibly good for Miguel twice. I think like 7-1 and 7-3 kill stats. So yeah, not surprised that he's trying it a third time. If he thinks he has the solid micro there. And so far I'm extremely entertained by the series. And Miguel even sending three villagers on gold here. That's Unconventional.
Is that in the with the intention of like trying to get to the archer transition quickly afterwards? I would think. Just wondering how effective like the Man-at-Arms Towers can necessarily be against the Gao's map, because he does have that eventually have that back stone to fall back on, and the goal should be defensible. So I have to see how much this pays off.
I think he will do nothing. Like seriously, he will pressure the berries a bit, and then he needs to fall back. I think he will. Miguel might struggle against the map of Togao here. On the other side, we now have the stable coming up for Nikov, and he might, yeah, at least annoy fire a bit. But after the first spearman comes out, I think his gold will be super safe as well, and yeah, not too much happening there. Oh, Togao is actually going for stable. Yeah, we didn't see him going for gold, so that's his obvious choice. And yeah, let's see. Maybe then M&A are a bit more efficient at the start, but still, there's no real damage he can do. He can still put a threat into the head of Togao, but real damage is not possible. Unless Togao misses the wall? Nope. Not Togao. Okay, more scouts coming up, fire building his archer ranges in front of gold spot to secure this area. And he's building lots of outposts, and I like this. I think that's a very undervalued building. Miguel now going for an archer range as well. Yeah, go ahead.
I was just saying, like, I just realized that Miguel didn't actually bring any villagers forward with those man-at-arms. I'm just surprised that he isn't accompanying with them, because he's just in a situation now where he can do nothing with those man-at-arms. He hasn't got any military at home. The scouts are coming to his, and they just seem totally wasted without having also taken some villagers forward to at least do some towers.
Yep, couldn't agree more, but that's mainly because he didn't have enough intel into Togao's map. Maybe he thought, okay, yeah, he won't wall and I can get in there and can block all the resources. But yeah, just some small walls, guaranteed. Yep, such a nice position there. Let's see, the villager might even go down. One scout in exchange and some damage done.
Because I was about to say, like, I really like what Miguel's doing. He's heading straight for that backstone as well to stop the guy moving over there on the assumption that he was had some villagers with him to start the tower, and it just never happened. So, you know, what I thought was a good play was just random sort of frustration because he couldn't manage to get in anywhere.
Okay, Miguel now going for, Nikov going for lots of stonewalling here, and he will go into knights again, but this time I think Miguel will struggle more with holding because his map is way worse, and he still didn't get the memo from Nikov that this time he needs to defend again. Let's take a look if he's getting some villagers home. No, not really. And if the double is coming to Miguel, I think he might go down to very low pop, to not give you any numbers.
But in the meantime, just for the next minute or two, he's okay with a couple of spears at home against those scouts. He's sending archers forward against Degau's berries, where the villagers are trapped because the man-at-arms are there. So he could be about to get three villagers from Degau really quickly here.
Okay, let's see. Oh, the M&A at the wrong side, but maybe can do some damage now. Blocking. It seems a bit like all the villagers might live. Oh, God. That could have been three kills, but maybe a bit of an early attack there, but still doing lots of damage and even getting some spearmen. And the low HP villager is going back to the front. What is Togao actually doing? One villager might go down. Let's see, 4 HP, but
yeah, slight loss of unit control there, I think, by Miguel. He had his man-at-arms in the perfect position to stop those villagers running towards the TC. And he just moved them around to the like south side and just allowed the villagers to slip by. Could have played that so much better, I think, and got those three kills.
Nikov doing a great job at staying safe at home against the archers and doing some killing at the same time, but now he needs to give the message, five archers are coming, dude, care, and yeah, better get a defensive tower up. I'm about to click and oh, this still might do some damage. Miguel, not in time. But he is in a sweet spot here. Let's take a look. Fletching now coming up for the Gao, actually finished. And the Gao losing another villager as well. Interesting game. I'm not really sure who to favor. Oh no, I know who to favor. And as we said before, Miguel is in a tough spot. And yeah, losing all the villagers and not getting his tower up. And yeah, Miguel, like we kind of predicted. Boah, not happy with the situation.
Yeah. I think Nico, I don't know how many archers he saw on the edge of his base, but yeah, he gave him the intel that it was five archers, and now they're just falling out instead of playing, and that's never a good sign. Never fills you with hope that they're actually gonna knuckle down and make their way back into the game.
Yeah, that's so true. And Miguel not trying to. Get his tower up, maybe not even cancelling it. Let's take a look at his stone. Uh-oh, he's not taking care. And this tower will actually go down without being cancelled.
Okay. Nico yelling in the chat, cancel the tower!
Okay, yeah, that's well done.
It does do it, though.
Oh, and now Miguel might even get one or two villager kills here against, against Fire. Villagers are super close overall.
I think Nikov can certainly bring them back in level in this game. He's only so much faster to castellate than anyone else. Got two stables.
Maybe
Fire and Degas still both 400 food.
Okay, let's see what Miguel can do with his 4 expos. Fire has enough. I think Fire can clear it up. Maybe Miguel can get one or two villagers. I think he will get two. But then his archers should go down. Maybe he's over. Maybe lose all the archers before he can actually kill that villager. Let's see. Togao open. Yes, for now. But if you're there with you. Depends on when you're coming with your knights, mate. Because Togao has one mission, and that's to be safe. And he's stonewalling with roughly 6 villagers at this time. So maybe he needs to attack Fire, who now is on 3 archery ranges and Spearman at home. So let's see what Nikov is doing. And what do you think? How many losses did Miguel take? Is he still in the game?
Let me just see where he is relative to Fire. No, Fire's clicked up. I think he's going to be a long way behind, isn't he? I'm just looking at the stone walls from Degau mainly, because I think those are about to have the biggest impact. It's just like astounding sense of timing, a game sense by Degau to actually do those, because Fire can defend. He's got 25 archers, spearmen. He can hold against plus 2 knights streaming in. Not plus 2, but double stable knights plus 1. But it was what those knights might have done to Degau's map that was going to be really, really pivotal. And Degau just completing those stone walls in time, with literally seconds to spare, is going to be possibly one of the most important things at deciding where this game's going.
Yeah, incredible stuff by them. And yeah, Fire now trying to defend here. Let's see how he's doing it. This wood is open. Knights are coming in. Let's see if he can get the quick walls running. Villagers obviously on the farm has no chance of survival here. And more villagers will go down. Fire, again, the player with the lowest overall villager count, but big army again. Let's see if Nikov is committing with his knights. Not sure if he can take this. Now plus 2 defense is finishing. Is he just trying to run around and then take a fight, or is he really retreating? No, he's really retreating other teams. Miguel now coming in as well, but actually they wanted to fight before Fire actually can upgrade his units now. Will be tough. Miguel on the way to Castle Age now as well. That's a good one for him. What is Dogao going for? He is going for knights. So they keep on with the knight expo composition like we kind of predicted. But yeah, Fire has enough army there to scare them away.
Just wondering where, yeah, the guy was sending all his knights to go and help out with fire. I wondered for a second with the direction the knights are going, if they're going to go and hit Nikov, which would be a spectacular mistake. I assume they're all aware of the four stone walls.
Yeah.
Yeah, more or less.
Okay, now Nikov is going and heal at home. Does he have so many low HP knights? Not really sure. And Miguel's army is now obviously super exposed. I'm not really sure if that was the nicest, like, team movement there. That he's leaving his whole army. And Togao plus two knights, so yeah, Miguel will lose everything. And soon it will be the huge army of fire again. Look at this again, 40 military and like what we saw before. And oh god, Nikov just opened his doors.
Fortunately for him, his TCs are covering most of the resources, and but even so, the amount of idle that can create if it goes in is huge.
And he can snipe some gold villagers over the walls as well. And Nikov indeed did clear up what Togao and Fire were throwing at him, but or throwing at Miguel, but now they need to defend against Fire. And Togao is sending everything as well. Let's take a look. Fire is keeping the production up. But that's a nice amount of crossbows. Let's take a look. Nikov's going now for the mangonel. Do you think Nikov and Miguel will be able to do the defense here?
52 army for fire saves, no. They're gonna need some hero mangonel shots, I think.
But some army behind, although now he's trying to regroup and get everything together. Maybe some mangonel shot to start it off.
That's a lot of knights for Nikov, though. Now that they've grouped up.
Yeah.
More hill advantage, but fire bringing another like 20 expos.
Let's take a look at
this. Could be the fight of the game.
Some expo hits. Oh god, that was a great shot there to start off the fight. So that's exactly what Nikov needed here. Mangonel now under fire. The crossbows can't clear up against the knight. And I think Nikov needs to retreat. He's very low on knights. Let's take a look. He's only at two stables. How many does Dogao has? He has two as well. But just the numbers for fire might be too overwhelming here. 52 military against a combined 35 of Miguel and Nikov.
Yeah, that main gold increasingly unsafe. A few more expos moving around the north side for fire as well. A lot of villages are just sort of randomly going down that Nikov is not saving, because he needs, sort of keeps needing to keep them working, and then it's just hard to keep your attention on garrisoning and then jumping out again. Looks like Fire and Degar will group up and head to the south. They don't really have any much siege to go up on that hill and push against the towers, but plus two knights can take towers down. However, the castle going up on the hill can save Miguel. It's going to be up in time. Yeah. Once again, exquisite timing in this game.
Exquisite timing indeed, yeah. The double could have been so strong, but yeah, that's so good. And I think Nikov now needs to go for more stables to go for something strong here in Castle Age. And Fire and Togao now playing ping pong, just switching away and back to Nikov. Let's see if they want to go for this gold here. And let's see how the engagement might go now. Miguel sending everything and Nikov, still only two castles and two stables. That's not enough, if you ask me.
Think he's gonna get this big fight. Looks like Fire and Degar. Just got so many more numbers.
Mangler shots. What's Nikov's production? Togao is sending in more, and he's adding more stables, so now producing out of four. Fire is sending in as well.
It is really quite well poised though, because although Togao and Fire retain the map control advantage, they're locking generally Nikov in their bases, well, in his base. They are just managing to hold the line just about, Nikov and Miguel, and they maintain the villager need. Like, Fire is really low in villagers. We did see him go low, of course. He went down to sort of like 35 as he was going up, but He hasn't recovered much since then. Only 49 now.
Let's take a look. He is at 2 TC, is now building a third one.
Yeah, maybe.
Now Plume Dodges by Miguel. He has ballistics as well, so see what he can do. More mangonels. Overall, this looks like a dead even game still. Maybe a bit better for Fire and Dogao, but the weaker army. It's only Crossbowman. Now Plume Dodge is finally coming in. They aren't retreating fast with Expos in the group. And Miguel adding more TCs, and he has already a pretty nice map control here for the later trade. Oh, the retreatment is bad. Nikov, how is he still only on two stables? Now he's going for the third one. And Dogao should absolutely outproduce him. Dogao at 27, Nikov at 18, and the military is just still so much better for Fire and Dogao all this time.
I think Nico's problem is that he never has enough gold like to actually produce for more than two stables reliably, especially with the need to add a mangonel here and there. But he's actually got 700 stone. Like, he should just, he's obviously been prioritizing that. He should just try and get that castle somewhere, because I think if they could just hold the line now, they'll be in good shape.
He's building it very aggressively, far away from the actual threat at the moment.
Yeah,
I'm a bit surprised by that. Handcart now coming in from Miguel. What is Nikov doing? He thinks he's not under threat enough, so now he is going for the raid. This crazy guy. Miguel's micro wasn't that great, losing lots of units there. Now adding a second castle though. And Fire and Dogao can't really do enough with their army at the moment. Oh, and nice interception here by Nikov, getting lots of Expos from Fire in the middle of the map. And this is the final fifth game we wanted, SMB.
Absolutely, yeah. It's just been swinging backwards and forth for like the last 10-15 minutes. It was really interesting contrast between someone like one team that got a little bit ahead in villages, one team went just really heavily into army, but just can't quite seal the deal, and game keeps stabilizing. I love the castle no location for Nikov though. At first it's not the most logical, but it's first of all shielding that main gold at the wood line, considering the left hand wood line is a liability for him now, and it's getting him close to that second gold, or second stone and third gold. I actually really like it, even though it wasn't the most obvious or perhaps even the safest castle to do. And the Gao taking, just sort of losing so many underneath that castle as well there. It's like even he was surprised it was there.
Everyone except Nikov. Oh no! Everyone just clicked Imperial Age, right? No, Miguel didn't.
Didn't Miguel just write in the chat that he's up? Yeah, Miguel wrote in the chat that he's up, and he's the only one that didn't click.
Okay, funny stuff. Let's see.
He's ready. He's got 1,000 of everything now.
But Miguel is going for the better units here. The Plume Dodges instead of the Obelisk coming up for Fire. And now I think most of everything. Win your corner. Oh, Nikov doesn't have cartography, obviously, because he knows, yeah, the corner is already theirs. And yeah, Miguel needs to send everything in the middle, or everything to Miguel, because that will be the most fought for area. More stables, still only 3 stables, now the 4th one for Nikov, and like 6 for Dogao here. Let's take a look at villages again. Fire 80, so better here for Miguel and Nikov. Who wants to fight now, or does everyone just wants to chill and get their upgrades because they think they're early up?
I'm not sure forcing a fight anywhere would be very beneficial for either, because both can retreat to a castle on the hill. I think something that's going to end up being important, like, is that obviously Miguel just been slightly earlier into that Plume Dodge transition. He's got an extra castle. Really like Bosal, what the hell actually, but I just like to. I think he can force the issue.
Oh, but we got a big fight here shortly before reaching Imperial Age. Bloom Dart just now from the back, and that's a better fight for Nikov and Miguel. And therefore, Fire and Togao retreating back to the hill, trying to take the better fight for themselves. But Nikov now says, let's go back, let's wait for all my upgrades. And yeah, now everything is coming in. Fire is building the second castle at the nice sweet spot here. Miguel a bit out of position. And he needs to send everything. How many castles does Miguel have? Now he has 3, I believe, indeed. And yeah, off of one of his gold spots, but then he should have a nice transition. Let's see, Fire, a bit of an overextension here. Cavalier upgrade now for Nikov coming in, but so it is from Dogao. What a great 2v2 game we are having here. Miguel's is researching braces and chemistry now. No elite plume dodgers just yet. First trap coming out for Nikov. Now trying to get all the castles down off Fire, but it's tough to protect the castle and the gold spot at the same time.
Miguel's looking in so much better shape than Fire as the mines player. He's got lots of resources in the bank to get all the upgrades, getting the conscription, elite plumed archer chemistry. There's no way that Fire is getting elite plumed archer anytime soon. I think that is going to have a really big impact as well. Like, Miguel will have an easier time building stuff in the north, like another castle up there, siege workshops. So I think Nikov and Miguel, despite the slight loss of like lower score at the moment, they can gain the initiative in the next few minutes, I think.
Why aren't they taking the fight here? I think Nikov could kill everything.
Like, are they actually going to wait 3 minutes for Paladin?
Oh, they're actually waiting for Paladins.
But
they're
Can be 3 castles against 1 in the Treb War.
Yeah, but Hans don't really need traps. Really need castles. He only needs conscription ones and has castles out. His traps out.
Nonetheless, it'd be nice to win a Treb War against the Mines player and take his castle out, but seems like the guy a little bit of overextension there, losing a lot of Cavaliers for very little, trying to save one of Fire's castles. And yeah, the guy losing loads, well, taking a lot more damage on Cavaliers, running, blundering even into those plumes.
Okay, Nikov now wants to go for the fight. Spread formation, patrolling in. Fire tries to build some houses in between. Now Nikov is going for the kill. Plume Dodges of Miguel still missing. And he said, I will sling your gold soon. Cavalier is now attacking, but Miguel is missing. He needs to go in and only killing villagers. And that's a great engagement here for Nikov. But it was just slightly before Paladin upgrade was kicking in. Why are you attacking just slightly before Paladin upgrade? You were waiting 2.5 minutes and now not patient enough to wait another 30 seconds. Goldsling is now coming in. That's pretty great for Nikov, who is only struggling in that regard. All the castles now for Nikov down, though. Plume Dodge is coming in, and even some in the middle. So nice ratings here by Miguel. Look out, trying to wall the whole map. Fire actually did quite a good job here. Fire only 2 castles. Paladin upgrade now for Dogao, finishing any second. Better population for Miguel and Nikov. And better units as well. Elite plume dodgers against normal plume dodgers. Can get traps. Oh, that's interesting. But actually, that's a doable task here.
Just noticed that Miguel has actually got banking. I didn't look in the research bar. I was about to say he should start to get coinage. Of course, you can't get coinage until Imperial Age with the mod we're using. But he's got banking and he can send a lot of food and gold to Nikov now. Nikov just flowing on 1,000 gold. And he'll be able to absolutely flood Paladins. I think that's going to be really important now. Miguel at that stage was a mines player where he's got like a massive plumes and he starts to float extra resources. And I think that's going to see them just sort of surge ahead now. They absolutely can't touch any trebuchets that Nikov produces from that castle. Fire will lose all his castles in the next few minutes, pretty much, in the north. And he put them all in one spot as well, which is always a risk.
It's always a risk. I think it was the right decision because it was the most fought for area. It was his gold and Nikov's gold there, so I don't mind that. But he just didn't get enough support by Dogao, who ran out of gold. getting some extra goals with the side. And now Nikov, I think, just continue to trap because that's good enough for you. And look at the amount of plumed archers here from Miguel. 80 military on the map from our Brazilian Mayans player. Everyone's spamming everything at this very spot. Fire still without any upgrades for his plumed archers. Now getting another second castle up. Some expos at a weird spot. And oh god! Fire doesn't have his third gold spot. And now the big fight. Probably the game-ending fight here. Because Miguel has so much army. Plumed archers of fire still on the hill. And there's just simply not enough yellow on the map. More paladins coming in for Nikov. The traps are raining down against the castle. Retreating a bit. Just waiting for the castle to go down and then take a better engagement. Third trap now should do the job. Or even scouting an extra stone spot. The trade, very slow if you ask me. A bit better here for Dogao and Fire. So maybe that might be a bad thing in the long run. Dogao continuing to raid against Nikov here. Super annoying for him, but he can deal with it pretty nicely. Third castle is actually gaining HP, although he's repairing against three traps. But the hill advantage is giving him, yeah, just a beautiful, beautiful way of saving his castle for now. Is there a chance for Fire and Dogao to hold here, Smibble?
Holding that area in the north is going to prove incredibly difficult. Dogao for a long time has been preparing a counterattack in the south. He's got a bunch of Seagrams there, but he doesn't have anything to go in with it. Like if he had sort of paladins to run in with that could grab back a little bit of momentum. Looks like he's just going to try and ram the castles though and hope Miguel doesn't notice. I thought he was going to go through the walls for the trade, although there's not much trade to hit. But yeah, once that hill is lost in the north, then it's going to be Nikov and Miguel going into the Fire's eco in the trade line.
Lots of access here by Nikov coming in. Let's see, villagers trying to kill the rams. Doing good job so far, but castles are coming in. At the same time, they are forcing the big fight here in the middle. Still no upgrades for Fire, and there's so many paladins. It's pop 200, pop 200, pop 180 for Dogao, and Fire only has 160 out of 160, trying to get more houses up. Only castle, crossbows, and plumed archers. But hides all the other Imperial upgrades except the last defensive upgrade. And now they are pushing the hill. Miguel's plumed archers are pushing. No more paladins left here for Dogao. The traps are unrooting and trying to get into the new position. Still no golden come for Fire. His other gold spot is in the trees as well. And this might be the final push here for Miguel and Nikov. He needs to try to hold over here. And Nikov sending in some on the side. Let's see, where is he standing? He's now building more stables in the middle. But the push over here is just so strong. Traps now going for the next target here against Fire. And trying to kill every production of our Mayans player from the full Brazilian team. And this ramp push is even denied. The castle's not going down. And therefore the production of Miguel is keeping up. And they're going for the final kill here, SMB.
Yeah, absolutely. Fire just about to lose his last castle. As soon as this goes down, Fire is going to be out of production for his plumed archers. He's just got elite and he's not even going to be able to make any more. And they're actually tapping out of the game right now. GG's. Nikov says, well played. I love you. Evidently valuing you. Miguel's just really strong play in this game. It was the plumed archer transition was really strong. And the fact that he just got well ahead of Fire in the eco, he was able to get all the upgrades like elite and just get the numbers upgrade, get that critical mass of Sling Nikov. Miguel really the MVP of this game here, and well deserving of Nikov saying I love you there. But what great games. This is like what I was envisioning when like I sort of created this tournament. I wanted lots of games like this, and this has lived up to the hype tonight, and I hope we get loads more like this.
Sick. What an incredibly good series here. And everyone playing just brilliantly. Fire just got so heavily punished and Castle Age was therefore behind, but massed so much. But then they did some damage against Nikov and he was struggling so much to get out in nice night production, but the worst timing to switch back to Miguel, he then got a castle, then going back to Nikov, never raiding his second gold spot, and Nikov just survived. And I think with a bit better scouting for Dogao and Fire, just trying to surround Nikov, they could have closed the game there, but Nikov stayed alive. incredibly and won them the game here. Wow.
Yeah, like scouting, you're right, is really key, because I think that second gold spot was something that kept Nico in it for long stretches of the Castle Age. If they'd have found that sort of second gold spot in the bottom left, which was totally exposed, Nikov sent 10 villagers out there, and that could have turned the game as well. Man, I'm exhausted now just sort of watching this. I don't know about the players. Don't know about you either after your full day of AOC.
Yeah, I started at like 14 GMT or something. No, 13 GMT. So, yeah. It has been some time. GG is indeed. Good. Okay. Then, SMB. Thank you so much for putting up this tournament and yeah, giving everyone the chance to watch those great players play here. And that's it from us. Tune in next time when it says Wubbly Official, Wubbly Stream is live. You wanted to say something?
No, I was going to say absolutely, and thanks very much for the stream. And thanks everyone for watching.
Ah, Manbeam says, Miguel, great last game. Indeed, Miguel did survive there. Finally, you played strong. Good job. Okay. Then, yeah. Thanks, everyone. And, yeah. Just give us feedback how we can improve. Give us feedback if you enjoyed the show. And we will try to provide you with more action here at Wubbly Official.
Good night.
Microphone muted. Microphone activated.
Yeah, we can talk here instead of typing. Are you bothered?